Mitosis is the division of the mother cell in number one into two daughter nuclei in number seven. So number seven represent the last phase of mitosis. Then cytokinesis happens, which is represented in number eight. Starting with number one, this cell is in interphase, in G2 interphase. Remember, interphase is not part of mitosis. So if we go back to this diagram right here, this is the G2, which is part of interphase. The cell did not yet enter the mitotic phase. In this phase, the centrioles has replicated into centrosomes. Also, the nuclear envelope is intact and visible. The nucleolus also is visible. The DNA containing material is in the form of chromatin. That's the chromatin. Moving to number two and three, which represent the first stage of mitosis, which is prophase. In two, we have the early prophase. In three, we have the late prophase. In the early prophase, the centrioles, they start forming the early mitotic spindles that pushes the centrioles toward the opposite end of the cell. Also, the nuclear membrane right here is still intact. The chromatin condenses into chromosomes. So this is a chromosome. That is another chromosome. Each chromosome consists of two identical chromatids. These chromatids are held together by the centromere, right here in the center. In number three, which represent the late prophase, here the centrosomes are still moving toward the opposite ends of the cell. And they are sending out these microtubules. The nuclear membrane breaks up to allow these microtubules from the centrioles to interact with the chromosomes. Moving to the second phase of mitosis, which is the metaphase. Let's go back to our figure right here. So far, we finished the prophase, early and late prophase. Now we're in the metaphase, the second phase of mitosis. In this phase, the metaphase, the chromosomes, we can see how the chromosomes, they line at the midline of the cell. So remember, metaphase, midline. The chromosomes are in the midline of the cell, and the centromeres are attached to the spindle fibers right here from the centrioles. We have one at each pole. Moving to the third phase of mitosis, which is anaphase, is represented by number five and number six. That is the beginning of anaphase, where the chromatids, these are the chromatids, which form a V shape, they are pulled apart toward the opposite ends of the cell. That is the end of the anaphase. The chromatids are pulled apart to the opposite ends of the cell. In number seven, we have the telophase, which is the last and final phase of mitosis. In this phase, we have identical sets of chromosomes at each end of the cell. The spindle fibers in red right here, they have disappeared in the telophase. The nuclear envelope in green forms to surround and protect the chromosomes. The nucleolus also forms. However, the two cells are still connected at the cytoplasm. Right here, cytokinesis, which is the division of cytoplasm, starts. In number eight, cytokinesis ended. Now we have two identical daughter cells like the mother cell number one.